Hello there, my name is Anshuman and you have started watching your own channel on visual merchandising and retail display. In this video, we are going to talk about VM portfolio. I have already made a video on how to make a VM portfolio using Microsoft PowerPoint, and that video is one of my best performing videos so far. So I have decided to take a step ahead, and now in this video, we are going to talk about how to make a VM portfolio using CorelDRAW. Now, if you don't know anything about CorelDRAW, so CorelDRAW is a design platform, is a designing software, which is frequently used by visual merchandisers and graphic designers and other designers as well. I have used very basic software skills for making this portfolio. So even if you are not well versed with CorelDRAW, this video can still help you. So now let's get to desktop mode and start right away. I hope you can see my screen now. This is the welcome screen of the CorelDRAW. Now you can click on the new document and a new document will open with the name, and it has other details. Page size is A4, width is in millimeters. You can change this as per your wish. Pressing OK. Now this is portrait. I want to make my portfolio in landscape mode. Okay, I have done that. Now I'm going to use only three things here. This one is rectangle tool, another one is this smart fill tool, and that's it. And using these two tools, I'm going to make a layout here, layout for my pictures. So before we do that, make sure that you have a folder ready. I have made this folder portfolio images. So I have like my graphic designing images here, some mannequin display pictures. Now I need to put everything in CorelDRAW, so that's why I'm just creating a layout here. So yes, clicking on rectangle tool, making a rectangle here. Okay, now I'm making another rectangle here, and I am just going to use this one. So it is selected, press Ctrl plus D, it's for duplicate, and then I'm going to rotate it to 90 degree. And this is done. So if you press P, it will be centrally aligned to the page. And let's do this. Let's place P again. So this is how the layout is going to be for my first page. And let's now insert page. So we will duplicate page so that we already have these things in the second page also. So yes. This is the page 2. Let's delete this because it is serving no purpose. Again, I'm pressing Ctrl plus D. Now we have got another rectangle here. So yes, let's shift this here. Let's shift this here. If you select this and press shift and select this, now you can press either T or B to make it top or bottom aligned. Okay, and Ctrl plus G to group this. Why I'm doing that, I'll tell you. So it is grouped. Now if I select this, these two things are grouped together. Now I'm pressing P again, it's centrally aligned. See, I have made a page with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 boxes, and here we have like 4. And then let's make another page. So I'm inserting a page before, I'm like duplicating page layers and their content. So this is my first page. I'm going to reduce this till here and reduce this till here. So we have page 1, page 2, page 3, and I don't think that we'll be needing more layout than this. So I'm starting with the first page. Now another thing which we need to do, we are going to use this smart fill tool. So click here, click in this box, click in this box, go to page 2. Cool. Now let's get rid of these lines. Delete, delete, and can you see this box, the big one which we created initially? Delete. Now we have these 6 boxes aligned, right? And for alignment, you can use this shortcut. Okay, now we'll do the same thing in page 2 and page 1.
Let's delete this. Delete this one. And let's get rid of this. This. And, sorry. This one.
So now we have these boxes. In page 1, I would like to give my introduction. So I'll just put my photo here. Maybe I'll. So I'm like just clicked on this text tool.
Portfolio. View.
Okay, now let's change this one to some nice font. Let's use this one, maybe. Whatever suits you. Let's use this for a while. So I'm making it big. Now, select this, press Shift, select this box, press C and press E. It will be centrally aligned. Okay, is it too big? Let's stop. Press Ctrl D now again, and then we can write by your name Anshuman. You can even make it centrally aligned by clicking here, center. Again, Shift, press this one, C and E. We can put a picture here. So now we are going to our folders. Let's put this picture here. So I'm like unable to name it. Control and C. Moving to this. We are pasting it directly here. Right. So now we have got our picture here. I want to put this picture in this frame. How I'm going to do that? Now there's a tool, you need to just left click here and you go to power clip inside, and you can see this black arrow just putting this inside this frame. It will automatically put this in the frame. Now there's a edit option. Now what you can do, you can select the content. Okay, now power clip again, you can extract the content, which will extract it. If you want to select it and then move it, you can do that. And we lock content so that you cannot play with the content. And if you want to edit it, you select edit. Now blue line shows the frame and this. Now I want to reduce the size. Let's keep it till here. This makes sense. Let's press on this finish tab. Okay, very basic. You can change the color. To red. To red. Let's play with blue. So I'm controlling this one. Let's make it blue. Let's make it. If you click, like hold the right click, then you will see this. A lot of colors, shades of the particular color. So this is my first page of the portfolio. As you can scroll for zoom in and zoom out. So now moving to the second page, here we can put four pictures. Now again going back,
and what I want to insert here is these pictures, maybe not these. Let's put,
press Control and click Control C and then paste it here. All three pictures have been drawn here. Now you can drag the corner to make them in same size, or you can actually, you know, this is the aspect ratio. You can lock this ratio and you can copy this figure. You can paste it here and the size will be more or less same. When you, I'm like doing this for this picture as well, I'm pasting it. Power clip inside. So again, power clip inside this frame, power clip inside this frame. Okay, now again it's time to Select the content and reduce the size.
Select the content and reduce the size. Select the content and reduce the size.
And I want to add some text here again. You can add text, whatever. So now again, press C, press E, and then you can play with none, full justified. Why not? And make it bold and make it white. Just click. Nice. See, we have some text, we have some images. And don't think of what image we are putting here.
In this way, I want to put this. In this way, put this one. In this way, put this one. In this way, this one will go here, and this one will go here.
Now again, the same process. Let's quickly do that.
Edit. That way you can just select it, edit it. Now it's cropping. But while you are doing it, you make sure that you make this layout in a manner so that you can display most out of your picture which you're putting. So I want to select content. Okay, select it. I want to place it here. Okay, works for me. Okay, now this one. Again, select the content. Oh, this is the same picture. But whatever the t-shirt option.
Layout completed. So this is the layout 1, this is the layout 2, and this is the layout 3. That's it. So this is my portfolio of 4 pages. Now how to export this, how to, you know, publish it. So we will press Ctrl plus E, or you can go to Files and then choose Export, and then you can select any folder where you want to save this. Anshuman portfolio. I want to save it as a PDF. If you have to put these pictures somewhere, you can use the JPEG. And when you select JPEG, only single page will be exported. And if you select PDF, let's see what options it provides. So see, we can actually publish or export the current document. We can publish the current page if you want to export this one only. Current document, you can select the pages. If you want to select 2 pages, you can go like 1 to 2 or 1 to 3. But we want to save the whole document here. Okay, and then PDF preset. If you have to make something which can be shared easily, then you can go for web. But you have to keep in mind that if you are selecting web, and the picture size and the quality will be reduced and the size of the document will be reduced. So I'm going for the web only. I have exported it. Let's see. I think it was in documents. Coral work. Yes. So this is my portfolio, which is a 441 KB. Oh, it's too small. And if you open it in the PDF, see. So the picture size is not that great. I'm zooming in and it's getting pixelated. So this is my portfolio. Next page, and the thank you page, and we are done. Now if you find the portfolio which we just made very basic, you can use your creativity and you can, you know, put lot of layouts and design options, and you can present your work accordingly. And if you are very new to CorelDRAW, you can start with the basic layouts. So that's all for today. So if you want me to make a video on any specific topic, you can let me know in the comments. I'll keep on bringing more content on VM and retail display, and I've been thinking about bringing some retail professionals, visual merchandising professionals to the channel, and we can have a chit chat with them and you can get to know a lot of things about VM and retail display. So stay tuned, keep watching and stay safe. I'll see you in next video. Goodbye, take care.